A very good evening to all of you, all my lovely viewers. I'm back. My name is Shilpi. I'm the Relationship Manager with the Global Education and Training Institute. Thank you, Ms. Priyanka Kalla, for joining in the disruptive education movement started by Dr. Sunita Gandhi. Ms. Kalla is here today to speak about a blended learning, which is the new normal after the post-pandemic. And let me introduce this pretty lady to you. She's the academic coordinator with the B.R. Birla Public School in Jodhpur. She is a scholar in a true sense because after studying MSc in electronics, she went ahead and did her master's in English literature, both of which are supposed to be difficult subjects. Then she has also worked right from the primary to the high school section in both, you know, in all kinds of environment, which is right, you know, from, you can say, urban to suburban and rural areas. So I think it has added a lot of experience in her academic career, which, you know, as an educationist spanning 12 years. So welcome, ma'am, and thank you once again for sparing time for us. So it's over to you.
Yeah, good evening, all the ladies and gentlemen, and thank you, Shilpi, for, you know, making my day. So, you know, yes, as rightly said, Shilpi, the variety of, you know, the classes and the variety of, you know, areas where I worked upon, it really helped me a lot to understand what are the actual for, you know, overall development of a child, right? So it was really very, very helpful to me, right? And today, as my topic is blended learning, post-pandemic, you know, it is a new normal. So just to begin with, what is blended learning, right? Because it is not new these days. We all know, like we have been, we as educators, we were in our comfortable zone. Teaching our students when they were coming to school, it was very, you know, the lesson plans were made according to, you know, that environment, right? But as you know, this due to this pandemic, it was so unexpected and unprecedented that everything, all the planning which we did for the coming session was all at, you know, it just go in waste. And we had to be, as, you know, educators, as parents, we have to really, it was a difficult time for all of us, right? Can you please do the next slide? Next slide, we shall be. So it was really, really challenging for all of us, you know. For parents, it was, of course, an added responsibility considering their personal work, work from home, household chores, as virtual classrooms are not as simple as plug and play. We all know that there is a direct positive correlation between parent involvement and students' academic success. So, hence, be it traditional learning environment or the current distance learning situation, it is imperative for parents to actively participate in their child's daily online learning. We as educators did face many challenges during, you know, this time of pandemic, you know, in making this blended learning, you know, a very, you know, systematic. So my main concept, my main, you know, concept, yeah, behind this talk show is it was really difficult for us, the kind of planning we did, but we had some, you know, some expectations from parents. And for me, when I see the current scenario, you know, as we are looking into the current scenario, again, the number of cases are increasing. So it's really, you know, as an educator, as a parent, again, it is the area of concern for the small children. So for me, how can a parent impact their child's online learning in a meaningful way? for us. You know, it's a request to all the parents and as parents and educators as parents as well, that we have to, you know, model a positive attitude for this mode of learning. You know, children model their parents' behavior and attitude. Whatever we speak, whatever, you know, comment we give for the, if we are not taking these online classes seriously, our child can never be. Since parents, right, children will take cues from them and will reflect their parents' behavior. So, you know, to make this learning successful, we really request all the parents to make it, you know, a model of a positive attitude, so that the result is really, you know, we can see a positive result in the child. Next, please, Shilpi.
You have to move the slides.
You know, and let's not criticize the online classes or school's efforts. Instead, let's point out the positives, how, you know, greatly their teachers have been working to make this new mode of learning comfortable for them. Let's not treat the online classes as a temporary arrangement, right? Because when it all began, we just thought it will be, you know, a matter of few days. Then, you know, it turned into a matter of few months and the whole session has been, you know, online. So let's not have an unrealistic expectations from our children as well and their teachers that magically the child will receive everything that's educationally necessary through internet. I know this mode of teaching cannot replace, you know, the physical teaching, but we as the stakeholders, we as the teachers and parents, you know, it's a joint venture to make it, you know, easy and stress-free for our children. We have to motivate our child to attend the classes in the same spirit as they used to love to go to school. Let's talk about the positives of the current pandemic situation. What was the positive things which we really had and how we turned the situation into something productive for all of us. Let's be empathetic and understanding towards classes and schools' efforts as well. Let's not allow our children to skip the online classes, suggesting everything would be repeated once school reopened. We shouldn't, right? And let's not hold back just because we are unable to see, use a certain technological tool. So, it is, you know, it's a request to all the parents because it was done. We have trained our teachers a lot, but there were some lacunas from the end of parents as well, because the environment, the parent, because when we were interacted with lots of parents, those parents who have been into the positive attitude, it reflects in the child's, you know, performance as well. And those parents who take it very casually and they were like, you know, ho jayega, ye ek hi saal ki baat hai. No, we have to be, because the time is again, you know, very, very uncertain. You never know. I know this is not going to be going long, but yes, we have to make our children ready for the future, right? And the very important thing while using this mode of learning is the constant monitoring. Now this is the time where children are spending most of the time at the home. Of course, maximum time at home using the, you know, the mobiles, laptops for the studies and everything. So it is, you know, parents' role to constantly monitor the child, because today's children are not just children, but millennial children. They are smart, they are technologically advanced, and they are confident, and sometimes they can be overconfident too, of course. They are children. So lack of supervision can also pave the way to mischiefs and naughty acts. So yes, we would definitely, because you know, children know all the aspects, they know everything, right? How to, you know, skip the classroom, how to, you know, use the those you know, sites on the incognito mode where my parents will not, you know, get to know what I was looking, whether I was studying or not. So yes, of course, parents, you know, need to constantly monitor what their children are watching, right? Yes, continuous involvement. The largest differentiator in a child's education is parent involvement. This online learning does not require the parent to be a homeschooler as assumed by many, because most of the parents have, you know, misunderstood and, you know, they were complaining, this has been difficult for us. Now we have become the homeschooler. Kya hame hi padhana hai? No, you are not. Of course, the teacher is doing their job. It is just you have to monitor them. Right, you have to act as a learning coach and facilitator who just help the children in the following ways. So what our expectation as educators from parents is, you please arrange the required devices and tools for learning to your boards, setting up a designated area for your children to attend the classes without disturbance, helping them completing their task on daily basis with the same zeal, same enthusiasm as they were doing in the school, helping them uploading their completed task on tools or apps as, you know, the school is asking for. You know, it is parents, you know, there should be compulsion of creating a routine as the routine was there while going to the physical schools, enforcing routine and structure so that they treat it as a normal school. So everything, you know, is in our hand. You know, as educator, as parents, how we create the environment to accept this new concept, this new normal of blended learning, right? Getting familiar with the child's e-learning tool and helping them navigate through too. So they also feel comfortable using it. Yes, and of course, cybersecurity is something very important, which the parent should also, you know, keep attending the workshops, you know, to get to know what all are the threats and how to, because once we just say it in the instruction mode to our children, don't use it, don't go, don't search these sites, they will definitely go. So you have to act, you have to treat our children, your children very tactfully, right? One more thing which I as an administrator and my teachers also faced was the intervention during online classes, right? So what my, you know, the request you can say to the parents, if some parents are watching today, just like in schools, the intervention of the parents is not required while the teacher is conducting the class. You know, we have to create that environment where the child is, you know, feeling the same as he or she was feeling in the school. It's always appropriate not to get in during online sessions or talk to the child. Child may get overly conscious if the parents are constantly coming in between sessions, talking to them or to their teachers, whether sometimes the child, you know, forget to, you know, mute themselves. So, you know, it looks so, and the child really, you know, face embarrassment in that. So it's a request for parents, you know, to accept this new methodology, you know, to make your children comfortable. Because until and unless we will not acquire this new methodology, you know, the child is definitely not going to adapt it. And the result we actually look for will be, you know, of no use. It won't be visible after this session. And hopefully things get normal in the new session. We are, of course, looking up for a normal session. Seek support and collaborate with school. This is something very, very important, because, you know, a child's development is the equal, you know, it is a shared commitment between the educators and, you know, the parents, right? So collaboration is the key to the mutual success of both the learners and learning leaders. So as a parent, seeking support from the faculty through phone, email, and messaging will definitely help build strong relationships and trust. And even the child, you know, they are the people, they, you know the psychology behind the parent. If he or she knows my parent is, you know, in constant touch with the teacher, definitely he will try to, you know, hide things from you, right? So a collaboration is really important. Then motivate, communicate, and encourage your child, because, you know, this mode of learning, which, you know, the means of this mode of learning is, you know, the phones, the laptops, which, you know, used to be the source of entertainment for the children, right? But now it is so very much unfortunate for the children, because now they were using it for the recreational purposes like games, cartoons, and movies. And now for them, their playing tool has become, you know, it is now become an education tool. So it is frustrating for them too. So we have to constantly encourage them, praise them after the session. And, you know, we should look forward for such sites where, you know, there are quizzes or games in the form of the, you know, curriculum, which can, you know, it will be a little recreational and a challenging job for them too. And, you know, lastly, we are not sure how long distant learning will continue, but yes, we do know that it won't continue forever. If we all will be, you know, alert enough, we all will be educated enough, of course, the situation we will, the current situation will definitely be overcome. So it is important for us parents to communicate confidence and optimism that we will pull through the crisis together. We need to set an increased value for education and learning by dictating online learning time, prioritizing needs, and giving personal attention. Managing our own emotions will help our children stay focused on their learning till school reopens. You know, and I just wanted, because when I was, you know, interacting with the parents and getting lots of feedback from the parents, I've started calling parents as MKOs, because they are the more knowledgeable others. You know, so parents are the partners of teachers in education. They are the home facilitators and the tagapatagole, that is the channel, but they will not teach the subject matter. It is the teacher's duty. But I would request all the parents and guardians to be responsible for interacting with teachers, the other stakeholders, to acquire the various materials and resources needed by the learner. Just keep a regular check on the child's work plan, as we were keeping the check during the schools as well as, right? Prepare a conducive learning space for your child and give appropriate praises, because we really want, you know, a stress-free environment for our children, right? So this is, you know, how, like, I want to conclude the session. You know, this is the new normal, which we all have to understand, and we have to. And this was, moreover, you know, a kind of, you know, a request session for the parents. And our expectations as educators from parents to, you know, make this kind of learning stress-free for our children. Any questions, Shilpi?
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Questions? Well, yes, I mean, so when we are talking about blended learning, would you like to explain this term to people who are people who are not educationists, and you know, they need to understand what is blended learning basically?
Basically, you know, Shilpi, we can say it is a distance learning, right? It is, you know, not new distance learning. Earlier, it is used to be, you know, through post via books. The books used to come from courier, the child or the person who could not go to the school. But now the source of studies is, you know, the media.
I believe there is a network issue on Ma'am's part. We'll just wait for a minute or two. She'll join us back.
Is it fine, Shilpi?
Ma'am, there was a network issue on your slide. So can you begin again?
Is it fine? Is it? Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
So I was just explaining blended learning in the simple language to you, that earlier also there was distance learning, Shilpi. There were many, you know, candidates who could not go to school, could not go to, you know, the colleges. They had some, you know, the most of them were, you know, engaged in some other thing. So that time people used to learn, you know, physically they were not present. But in the colleges or the premises, but they used to ask for the books from the couriers or from the post, and they used to write the exam, right? It is the same way. Yeah, it is the blended learning in new, you know, this century, right? Where the children are not able to go to school, they have to study using those books, through media, right?
Okay. And so is blended learning applicable to all, you know, levels of education, right from pre-primary
yes.
to high school?
Yes, because, you know, the year 2020 was, you know, a very unexpected and, you know, unprecedented year mm-hmm. where, you know, the technology was there in the school, but up to a limited extent. But when everything was shut down, the, you know, the most enormous effect was on the educational sectors, right? And we waited for, you know, a month of March and April. But when looking into the current scenario, we, you know, the learning cannot be stopped. So this is how the schools were ready with this, you know, the concept of online teaching for all the age groups. It was new for everyone. Yes, but yes, you know, we all learn, we all find the ways to make it more innovative and acceptable for all the age groups.
Challenges must have been more for some of the levels.
Of course, challenges were, you know, the most for the pre-primary and primary level, Shilpi.
Yes.
It was, you know, too difficult for the teachers also, and to, you know, get the connection to make them sit you know, in front of the computers and laptops, because they love to hear the stories in the laptops, they love to see the movies in the laptops. But seeing the teacher is fine, but the moment the teacher is asking to write something is something, you know, unacceptable for them. So what not the teachers have done to make it, you know, innovative and interesting for them. So hats off to all the teachers.
That is why I asked this particular question, because it's not just, of course, it's a very serious issue. But I also found it very, very funny, because, you know, in pre-primary, getting online and, you know, children, it's so difficult to even control them in the physical classroom to especially make them write.
Yes, and you know, yeah, and that is why I chose this topic especially for parents, Shilpi, because, you know, the teachers were ready with everything, but what was missing was the control of the teacher, because teacher is on the either side of the screen. So for teacher, had it been a normal class, the teacher has done every, you know, petty thing to make the child sit at the place, or, you know, to make the teaching in such a way in which child even can roam. But the main stakeholders were parents this time, and parents are not the educators, right? So, you know, they used to give up very soon. Mamas used to give up, ke main kaam karu ya fir ab isko bithane lagu. So it was difficult for us.
I know, yes. I believe that, because, you know, we saw our teachers in the pre-primary. They had to think of so many activities, you know, all the time.
They were.
You know, keeping them engrossed. I mean, normal lessons,
yes.
even which have been taught easily in the class, had to be put
yes.
into some kind of activity.
Something.
So, yeah.
Yes. An activity that, too, you know, all the activities different from other. Nothing
yes.
be repetitive
yes.
can be done. Yes. Yes.
Thank you so much, Ms. Kala, for being here and, you know, sharing such valuable thoughts over this blended learning. And I
yes.
think we hope so that the new session begins on a normal thing. But I believe that this kind of learning is actually a peep into our future. You know, this is how things will be in the near future also.
Yes, thank you. We have to be ready. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, ma'am. And now for our viewers who have been watching us, Getty has always been dedicated to teachers training, which we are again going to start in April. So our trainings include project-based learning and advanced spoken English, along with listening from the heart. All our trainers are from abroad. So for more information, you can contact us on the number coming on the banner below.